Metropolitan Detention Center had a lot of overcrowding issues in the last couple of years. It shipped hundreds of inmates out of state. But as we've reported, the county is now starting to bring those inmates back.
Well, one group is speaking up, saying there is still one issue we can fix. KOAT Action 7 News reporter Angela Brower is live in NBC to explain how it'll prevent overcrowding in the near future. Good morning, Angela.
And good morning to you. That group is the Criminal Defense Lawyers Association. And then there's also one county commissioner that is agreeing with them that really we are doing this business all wrong.
Thousands of inmates sit at the Metropolitan Detention Center. A lot of those inmates, though, we're told, haven't even gone to trial yet. One group is now asking what happened to innocent until proven guilty.
Stop housing pretrial detainees in jail.
The Criminal Defense Lawyers Association says the biggest problem Bernalillo County has, it's taking too long to get offenders into court and sentenced. They're waiting at MDC in some cases almost a year to see a judge.
274 days.
In other places around the nation, it takes less than 3 months.
If you look at other large urban counties like Bernalillo County across the nation, in 90 days, you have about 39% of cases go from charge to final disposition. If you look at Bernalillo County, the same number is 2%.
A lot of it because the courts are constantly granting continuances. Coit and County Commissioner Wayne Johnson say the courts need to lower bonds for nonviolent offenders and let them out, wait for trial at home. And in turn, we can close the doors on this overcrowding issue for good. Now, here's the thing, too. We're told there are several people being held right now that have $25, $50 bonds, and they can't afford it. And so, therefore, they're sitting at MDC, and you, as the taxpayer, are paying for that. Reporting live at MDC this morning, I'm Angela Brower, KOAT Action 7 News, more in the morning.
Angela, thank you for that. We're told at one point commissioners were considering paying $40 million to add on to that detention center. No word on whether that is still on the table.